Hello guys, welcome to another episode of the Whisky Diaries. I'm your host, Martin Lang, and today we're going to be talking about Kilchoman. Now, it's a little bit of a complicated name to say because we have to, most people say Kilchoman, but it's actually, the C is actually silent, so it's pronounced Kilchoman. Kilchoman is the first distillery in 124 years to appear in Islay in Scotland. Islay is a little island west of Scotland, and they're famous for producing smoky whiskey. The reason for the smoky whiskey is because of peat. Now, Islay is a very barren island. I've been there in 2014, and it's basically the snow tree, very little fuel. So what they used to do back in the day to malt the barley and just to dry the barley, they used to grab peat from the ground. Peat is basically decomposed moss and dirt that is just happens from tens of thousands of years. And what they do is they grab the peat out, big logs about probably 1.5 meters, almost 2 meters, about yay big, and they put it and then dry it for 2 or 3 months, and then they use that as fuel. Obviously, as you can imagine, burning dirt produces a lot of smoke. So what it does when you dry the barley is the barley absorbs all that smoke and it creates what you call smoky flavor or peat, phenolic parts. Now, Kilchoman has a little bit of a special place in my heart because it's one of the first distilleries I went in Islay in 2014. And it's the cutest thing. It's just a tiny, back then anyway, it's a tiny distillery. It's basically a farm. They're more famous for the cattle and like just a farm, really. So the distillery, when I went there, it was two stills in the side of a little shack, like literally just tin shack. They do their own barley, they do their own malting floors, they have their own little bottling plant. And what this, so it's one of the only whiskies in Scotland that they do everything from start to finish. So you can call, basically you can say from farm to bottle, which is quite unique because most of the major distilleries and stuff, they basically grab things because they're so big and they produce so much that they can't produce everything themselves. So to have a little farm producing certain type of bottles and certain type of whiskey from scratch is actually quite special. Now they do, because it's such a small family-owned business and distillery, they can play around with a lot of casks and a lot of variations. So what we're going to talk about today in Kilchoman is the five basic releases, things that you can buy or that you can get in most places. I do want to mention that they produce hundreds of casks, like over the course of the last 10 years since they opened in 2005, sorry, 14 years since they opened in 2005, they have released hundreds of different versions, from Saturn casks to Madeira casks, sherry casks, the whole lot. Now, the latest release that they just released, I think it was this year or last year, is the Sanaig. All the names from Kilchoman bottlings are from different areas around surrounding the distillery. So Sanaig is a little trail of like a little river behind the distillery in which they get some of the water for the distillery itself. And it's basically more sherry driven. So this is an American oak and sherry cask. The Casca Oloroso sherries. And what you find with this one in particular is that it's a little bit more, they age it longer in sherry cask bourbon. The reason why I mention that is because a couple of the other versions, they don't, they're more bourbon forward. Now, most of the bottlings come at 46% alcohol, so they're quite strong. So that means that you probably want to use a little bit more water when you taste it, but we'll go that into a second. So that's Sanaig, a little bit more sherry driven. Now, the second one, this is one of the first releases that they did. I can't remember exactly what year it was that they released, but it's called Machir Bay, and this is a continuous release. You can always find it. They keep doing it and redoing it. Machir Bay being where the distillery is close to the bay that is called Machir Bay. Now, this, again, is 46% alcohol, and like Sanaig, it's both aging American and Oloroso sherries. But this one is more bourbon driven. So it spends a little bit more time in American oak than about the sherry. So this has a little bit more vanilla overtones and everything. Now a little bit tidbit story for Kilchoman is that it's a tiny, as I said before, it's a tiny little farm. And they don't have a big, like most other distillers, I've been to a few, they have like big signs that says Glenfiddich or Balvenie or whatever it is. I tried to get to Kilchoman myself when I was on the GPS and driving through this little tiny road and you can't even see it, and you go past a farm and the farm itself says, oh, we are a farm, and it doesn't have a lot of signage. It's actually a tiny little sign at the bottom that says, oh, Kilchoman Distillery, turn here left. You can't even see it, and it's just like a tiny road in the middle of nowhere. It took me like back and forth 100 times to be able to find it. And I find that really, really incredible. I personally enjoy that kind of stories and that kind of like uniqueness and like, what is it, like feels real. The next one that we're going to try is Kilchoman Lochmore, or we were going to talk about it. This is what we're actually going to try later on when I finish with the other two. Lochmore, again, Loch Gorm is actually one of the lochs around the distillery as well. This one is different to these two because it's 100% Oloroso sherry, and you can see by the color already. So this one is more American oak, so it has like a more clear color. This one is almost like dark brown, almost red. So that's what sherry casks that to a whiskey. Now the reason they do Oloroso sherries in whiskeys is it's a completely different flavor profile to what you would get from bourbon. It's one of my favorites. I prefer sherry casks a lot more than bourbon, but it's a preferable taste. Obviously, tasting whiskey is a lot more subjective. So as I said, 100% in Oloroso sherry cask, and this is again 46% alcohol. We're going to try that in a second. This one is when we start going into, this is one of the selections that we have, but this one is run finish. So this is one of those releases that get released once in a while, and they just experiment with different types of barrels. In this particular one, rum being from the Caribbean, I'm assuming it will be from Cuba, just because distilleries in general share casks. And I know that Balvenie, for instance, a lot of the Caribbean casks that Balvenie uses are actually from Cuba. So once Balvenie uses those barrels, other distilleries might be able to buy them from them. This is basically what I'm guessing. I'm not sure 100% where they get the rum cask from, but I would assume that would be the case. So they do rum cask, they do, as I said before, Madeira, they do types of sherry, cognac barrels. They've done a lot. And I love that about that, because it's just like you can, it changes the flavor of the whiskey so much. So that's the rum finish. And then the final one, that this is something that is almost like a continuous version, but different editions. So this is the 8th edition. This is the Kilchoman 100% Arla. When they put 100% on Arla, means that everything that goes into this whiskey is produced and made in Arla. It's really interesting because it's actually really, really hard to grow barley in Arla. It's a very barren, deserted, like it's very green, but it's like super windy. There's a lot of salt from the ocean. It's just very, very unfriendly, if you want to put it that way. So to grow barley there is actually quite hard. The barley that grows there has a very low yield, alcohol yield. So it's something that they're very proud of. So that's why they put 100% Arla in the bottle. And this is, as I say, the 8th edition, but they keep releasing new editions. And they're actually incredible. And most of them are over 50% alcohol. This one in particular is 50 on the dot. And yeah, as I said, it's incredible whiskies. Now, what we're going to do, we're going to try the Lochmorn. I can never pronounce that one properly. And it's 100% sherry cask, 46% alcohol. And this is, as I said in previous episodes, what you want to do is you just want to pour a little bit, like maybe a shot in there, and then give it a little bit of swirl, have a little smell. Once you taste it, oh, that's beautiful. Once you taste it, you want to give it a scale from 0 to 10. 46% alcohol, I would say probably 7, 8. Because it's quite strong. And then what you do is you just put your waters, as always. So between 0 to 10, I give it a 7. So 7 drops plus 1 for luck. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then again, you just give it a little swirl like that. have a smell and you'll feel all the aromas coming through. This one in particular, obviously the smoke comes through really strong. All these whiskies are between 40 to 60 ppm, depending on the release. But then behind the smoke, you can always find like dry sherries, sorry, not dry sherries, dry raisins, dry apricots, a lot of like Christmas pudding style of flavors. This goes great with any type of food. It's amazing. Yeah, that's great. So thank you guys very much for listening. And slán jabá.